Namaskar everyone, I am Devang Dimri from Indian Culinary Institute and I am here to demonstrate Korean style bulgogi duck with twisted Indian flavors. So let's begin without further delay. So before beginning with our preparations, let's take a look at our ingredients that we require for preparing the bulgogi duck with twisted Indian flavors. So first of all, we'll require sticky rice, and we have already soaked it in water, and we need to soak it for at least an hour before using it. Next, we'll be requiring some veggies. I have taken sweet potatoes, which I have cut into dice, then zucchini, some red chili peppers, and portobello mushrooms. For marination, we'll be requiring garlic powder, red chili powder, rice wine, soy sauce, garam masala powder, sea salt, and some oil. So using these ingredients, we have prepared a marinade for the duck, in which we have also added chopped ginger, chopped garlic, and some fresh thyme. So let's begin marinating our duck. We'll take the marination and pour it all over our duck nicely, so that marination reaches every part of the duck. And after we are done with marination of duck, we'll allow it to rest for at least a couple of hours, so the duck absorbs the flavor really well, and when we cook it, it comes out really juicy and succulent. Now after pouring the marinade, it's time to massage the marination into the duck, and we have to do it really well so that the duck absorbs the flavor and it comes out good and tasty. Now our duck has rested for a couple of hours, and now it's time to put it in the oven for roasting. We'll roast it at the temperature of 180 degrees Celsius in a preheated oven for around 20-25 minutes. And after every 10 minutes, we'll continuously bask the skin of the duck so that the skin doesn't get dry and it stays moist and crisp. So till the time our duck is cooking, we'll continue with our rice preparation. For that, we have to boil rice with a little bit of salt for 8 to 10 minutes. So let's add rice and let's turn on the heat. And we'll let it boil till the water is completely absorbed by the rice and it becomes sticky in consistency. So the best thing about Korean food is that it is well balanced. It consists of everything from meat to legumes to vegetables to lentils. So it's kind of a healthy food. And nowadays, as we all know, healthy food is so important. And in the modern times, people are also attracted towards trying the Korean foods, trying the different Korean dishes. So let's start our vegetable preparation. First, we'll heat some oil in a fry pan. Once it heats up, we'll add in zucchini. We'll add in a little of sea salt and give it a quick stir. We don't have to overcook the zucchini, we'll just keep it a little al dente. As you can see, our zucchini is cooked and it has got a nice golden brown color to it. So it's time to turn off the heat and take it out. In the same pan, we'll add in the sweet potatoes. And again, some sea salt, just to give it a nice flavor. Sea salt will also help in preventing from sweet potatoes from being bland. Again, a quick toss. And again, We'll not overcook the sweet potatoes. We'll just keep them to a al dente consistency. The sweet potatoes are cooked nicely. They are not fully cooked. They are still al dente and have a nice golden brown color and a nice crunch on their outside. Now it's time to take them out. Now, in the same pan, we'll add the portobello mushroom and let it cook till it gets a nice color on the outside. Our mushrooms are done and ready. Let's take them out. Our duck is done and ready. You can see it has turned out beautifully. The color on the outside is so mouth-watering. The skin, it's so crisp and yet moist. And I can say that I'm actually happy with the way it has turned out. And we are also done with our vegetables. And our sticky rice is also done and ready. So now it's time to assemble all these three together. And for that, first what we'll be doing is, we'll be carving our duck. We'll be taking out two drumsticks and we'll put them on the top of the rice. So let's take out the drumstick. So we'll cut the drumsticks and here's the first one. Now we'll take out the second drumstick. Here we have a beautiful second drumstick. So before we start assembling, let me tell you the things that I've used in this plate. I've used the zucchini shavings as the base. Then I have used bean sprouts and Chinese cabbage to act as a bed for the rice. And also I have dusted some parsley powder and red chili powder onto the plate. So for plating, we'll first take a nice scoop of our sticky rice and put it on the bed of Chinese cabbage and bean sprout. Place a good nice drumstick on the rice very carefully so that the rice does not shatter. A little desi tadka to give it a nice desi flavor. Contains all the flavor of a marinade. So thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you got to learn something today.